replaced him, Mike Schilt. You know, Mike take is, he like checks off a lot of boxes. Very likable, real thoughtful guy. Knows everybody in the organization on the back of his hand. But I'm telling you, he may be like, you know, getting on the Titanic because it's starting to sink.
I don't know that we'll have an answer to that until we see what kind of moves this team makes in the trade. And until we see what kind of moves this team makes.
I don't think he'll get the job.
Really? What if they had a nice stretch and they finished 7 games over .500?
He still wouldn't get the job. If they snuck in and got a playoff berth, the second wild card, it would be more difficult maybe to bring in a new manager. But I just don't see him getting that job.
I think it depends on what direction the franchise wants to go. Do they want to like kind of move out some of the older guys, turn over the kids that won the last several years, and have like kind of hold them into a team that maybe it takes another year or two to become a playoff team? I could see that. But we've seen going out and signing free agents doesn't work. You should overpay to get them here, and the production doesn't match the salary. This team needs a star player. It needs somebody to be the focus of the franchise that they don't have right now. I don't know who that guy is. I don't know if I could be, but if they get that guy here, I don't know. So I think there's just too many unanswered questions to get an answer on that guy. I think Mike Schilt is very qualified. I think he does a great job. I've known him a long time. I don't think the role of him. What he used probably to do in describing the situation, you're getting a job as bittersweet.
Yeah.
But he's out of bounds, so let's see what he can do.
I'm listening to, I guess, MLB Network late last night as I'm driving home, and they're talking about the Cardinals and what they're going to be looking for. And they said, well, you got to hire that Joey Cora type. That's the trend. Well, as long as Joey Cora comes with Mookie Betts and J.D. Martinez and Chris Sale, hire the guy. Nobody's, the paraphrase James Carville, it's the roster, stupid. It's not going to be Schilt's fault if they're a 500 or less team and they finish in fourth place behind the Pirates.
Well, what's going on in the roster?
All right, Dusty Baker gets you to the playoffs, but he's not good enough. So they go they are 500.
Yeah, you think we're getting less out of New York? Oh, my God. Nobody's underachieving like that.
They are the biggest underachiever there are, at least in the National League. And so, thus, that mold you're talking about, well, that doesn't necessarily fit all. So
I guess it kind of depends on this, too. How much influence does John Mazzella Cavalier go away in making this decision as who the manager is? Because they've groomed Mike Schilt for this job. Maybe it wasn't exactly the timing that they wanted him to take over, but he's the guy that they want to be in charge of. So at least John Mazzella wants to be in charge of this team.
Could John Mazzella be under any scrutiny? Well, not definitely under scrutiny, but you think his job could be on the line?
He's got this trading deadline, he's got the winter, and he's got half the season next year to, because they might say, Rob, like you said, they might decide to change the team. And if they change the team, then all you can do is wait to see if it pans out. So I'm not necessarily thinking that Mazzella will be out of the job between now and this time next year. But does he see the 2020 season? I don't know.
Your suggestion of Nolan Arenado is a great suggestion, but I don't see the Rockies are still relatively in it.
I don't see it now. I would see that happening over when he's going into his last year out there. You know, they can talk to everybody, not just a contending team, about what kind of package would you give us for him, because he's not going to resign there. He's always going to talk about wanting to go to a winning team, but again, the same one's qualified as that after the last couple of years. I don't know, but. I don't see that happening by 4 next Tuesday, the trading deadline, but I would think if he's not traded now over the winter, that's got to be your number one target.
By the way, I think I meant Alex Cora. So who is the solution if you're not going to get Machado, you're not going to get Harper, and let's say you don't get Arenado? Where is that impact star back?
Oh, man. Stavis? Maybe it solidifies your first base, but I don't know.
Did you want to stop this here?
Depending on what it would take to get in. I mean, again, we could have signed him last year.
And they didn't. Good point, and I agree with you on that. I don't know what that, why they were hesitant to do so, but they had their reasons, and I'll live with not having.
I think there's a lot of talent in the Cardinals organization right now. you know, been on this soapbox before, but I'd like to see what some of these kids can do before I go out and spend a ton of money on a lot of players like that.
Yeah, let's take a break. I want to get to that.